Okay, I will talk about how a coding bootcamp helped me in my tech career. So I will start with this agenda. I will talk about myself, then I will talk about the tech ladies bootcamp that I attended, how I got involved with the bootcamp, about the bootcamp project. This was a 3-month project that we worked on. Then my learnings and my takeaways from the bootcamp. And then maybe some question answers if your people are interested in. Okay. So I am a software engineer with around 7 years of industry experience in India. So technically, I'm not a junior dev anymore. But I call myself a junior dev because I took a break in my career for 3 years after I moved to Singapore in 2014. And after that, I did not want to continue in the same technology that I was working in. So I was looking out for new technologies to work on. And because there were so many of them, it was very confusing and difficult for me to decide which one to choose. But this bootcamp gave me an opportunity to learn new technologies, and that is why I'm calling myself a junior dev right now. Okay, so my interests are, as you know, programming. I like to solve problems, be it jigsaw puzzles, be it puzzles with kids, be it real life problems, whatever. Then I like spending time with kids. I have 2 kids, by the way, my 8-year-old and a 3-year-old. I like traveling. So I'm always after my husband to take me out somewhere. Then I like socializing and networking. I like meeting people, talking to them on various topics. Then, as you know now, from whatever I've shared with you till now, is like I worked, I took a gap, spent time with my family, and now I'm back to work. So that's all about me. Now, tech ladies. It is a community for women in Asia to connect, learn, and advance in as programmers. And the bootcamp is one of the many things that tech ladies do. Okay, the bootcamp was a 12-week intensive program that ran from August to October 2017. I was able to participate in that because I wasn't working at that time, looking for a job, waiting for my work pass, whatever. So, but it was a blessing in disguise. Okay, how I got involved in Tech Ladies and this bootcamp. So as I told you, I like socializing, networking. I was browsing through my Facebook account and I came across this ad about the bootcamp. I was just about to scroll up. Something held me back. I saw it. Okay, thought about attending the info session. But then being a family person, a lot of things keep on coming and I was about to miss, not attend that, but finally somehow made it. So I was curious to know what this Tech Ladies is, what is the concept of a boot camp. So I attended the session in which I was told about what they do, what kind of projects they work on, how it works on. So I was actually very impressed to know that, you know, there will be people who would actually mentor us and coach us, taking out time from their work schedule. Then after the bootcamp info session, we had 3 pre-bootcamp workshops in which we were introduced to the technology that we would be using for the project in the bootcamp. So I attended those sessions and got the understanding of the technology. And then we were given a programming assignment. That was a task. Okay, so within a few days or 3 weeks of self-learning, we were supposed to submit a task, which was to be evaluated. And I had no hopes I would clear that. But I was surprised when I got the confirmation email and I got to know I was one of the selected, I was selected out of 86 people who had applied for the bootcamp. And then that's how the bootcamp journey began. So the bootcamp was from August to 2017. That's a 12-week program. And I would like to thank Michael, my coach. So he was the one mentor who would I will always look forward to for any problems I have. Okay. What this bootcamp was, or what the project that I worked on was about. So we were supposed to develop a website for Mountbatten Vocational School. The reason why I was interested in this project was because it was a live project. it would be used in real life, and it would actually benefit them. So this is a vocational institute in Singapore whose record keeping was all manual. They have been running this institute for the past 30, 35 years, and still everything was manual, record keeping. So that's the workflow we learned in the bootcamp, that the first phase is the requirement gathering, then how do we design, how do we create the database, create the tables, capture where we would store all the information, and how we will do the development. As you can see, we start from story selection, then we go on to the test-driven development, push to GitHub, continuous integration happens. All that was new to me. This is the requirement gathering phase, me with my team. We visited the school to understand how they are currently working, what they want from us. So how do we store all that information? Then once we had all the requirements, we had to divide them into small chunks, which one to work on first. Was all done using the Pivotal Tracker tool. Test-driven development was a new concept to me, because from my past experience in IT, I thought that can never happen. Okay, so then we also learned about the continuous integration and code climate, and I realized that, you know, actually a lot of things had changed over those 3 years when I was on a break. So that was another reason why everything was looking new to me. Okay, what my learnings are, and all these learnings that I have are still helping me in my current job. So the first thing I learned was about agile practices. So while on a break and I wanted to get back to work, every profile I would come across, job description, would say agile, agile, agile. It would bang on my face, agile. And I was like, how come I'm so old school? I don't know about agile. But then this bootcamp, yes, it helped me to understand what agile practices are, how you divide your work into smaller chunks, and you choose which one to work on first, how you get a continuous feedback on whatever you are developing, and daily stand-ups, in our case, weekly stand-ups. But yes, it was a good way to understand about agile. And I'm still using it in my current job. So this has helped me to transition well into the new world for me. Then I also learned about web technologies, because the project was based on Ruby on Rails. Although I'm not using web technologies in my current job, but knowing about them is always a plus. It helps you understand the functionality of things around you in a more detailed manner. Then, as I mentioned, I learned about the continuous integration and continuous development and source versioning system, Git, as we all know. I'm still using it. And for continuous integration, I'm using a different tool, Jenkins, at my workplace. But again, very informative, very easy to learn, I would say, at least the basics that I'm learning right now. Test-driven development. I wouldn't say I'm using it directly in my work, but again, having an understanding of test-driven development helps me at a daily basis, because I'm also doing test automation. So it gives me a clarity of, you know, how do I need to write the test or automate the test, keeping all the requirements in, thinking about all the requirements. And another thing I learned in the bootcamp is the programming techniques. So when we started with the bootcamp, we used to sit in a group, discuss about things, learn about what is mob programming. And later on, in the fifth to eighth week of the bootcamp, we did pair programming, where I would eat Michael's head all the time to help me solve the problems that I'm facing. But it was a very good experience, because it gave me more clarity on what my weak points are, how to approach to a problem, and how to find a solution. It also taught me that it's always good to Google things, and you'll find answers. One more thing I learned is retrospective. It's more about taking regular feedbacks to understand how you're performing or how you're doing in the project. What are the positives? What are the negatives? What you feel good about? What you feel bad about? What you want to change in the next iteration or the cycle? So I think my coaches were good enough to follow all the best practices in coding, which I'm not sure if we are following in actual work life or not. So that's all about me, my learnings, my takeaways from the bootcamp. And I would encourage everyone to, you know, participate in such things apart from your job. Keep on learning something new, because learning always helps. So that's all about my talk. Thank you.